I want to thank God for the mighty works that He has done. Not only in my life, but also in the life of this church. In the life of the man servant, the Reverend Reginald Morton, who has done a great work. I want to thank you, Reverend.
God bless you. Thank you, Pastor.
For your loving kindness. Your words of encouragement. And I thank you for this opportunity. There are at least 1,000 preachers between here and there. And you could have easily chose any one of them. But you thought enough of a small, short country boy from Arkertown, South Carolina.
It's all good. Hallelujah.
And so I thank you. I'm humbled. And I thank God for my sister, my classmate. I have been on the same journey for a long time, and I thank God for you, your loving kindness. You have not wavered. Your character has not wavered, and so I thank God for you. Thank God for my wife, Sister McFadden, and my mother, who has been traveling with me for the last 2 nights, and I thank God for my son, Joshua, who is also with us tonight. Let me take this opportunity to charge this not to my head, to my heart, but to my head. My brother, Reverend Huff, Sons of Allen president of the Newberry District, slipped by me last night, but I thank God for you, my brother, for the work that you're doing in men's ministry in the Newberry District. And certainly to the chairman of the board, the late president of the Newberry District, Sister Cynthia Tolan. Because we can't do anything without the ladies.
That's right.
Isn't that right?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So we thank you for making the ladies strong in this district.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And to Mount Moriah, to Mount Zion.
Amen.
And they're very fine and capable pastors.
Amen.
Reverend Rosetta Gallman.
Yes.
And Brother Gallman.
Bless you, brother.
We thank God for you, my brother.
Yes, sir.
Nobody but you and Traveling Shoe.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, brother. And certainly to the young lady who said that she's a member of St. Matthew. She says she's a member of Shiloh and also a member of First Natalie. And so we thank God for you as well.
Amen.
And certainly to the love of my life.
Yes,
the Bethany A.M.E. Church.
Yeah.
In Jonesville.
Right. Set it up, Pastor.
Kevin Kelton.
That's it.
The Eisentown community.
In Harper Road.
Of Union County.
Yeah.
Where we are doing big things.
Yeah.
Go ahead. And so we thank God for you. For your sacrifice. You all have been with me all 3 nights.
Amen.
Adult choir on Monday night, the senior choir on Tuesday night, and the combined choir on Wednesday night.
Amen.
And so we thank God. It's not our intention to hold you very long. We'll say a few words and then we're going to leave it alone. I want to refresh your memory how the Lord has been leading us these last few days. He took us to the book of Isaiah and inspired us to preach from I Don't Mind Way.
That's right.
Then he led us into a valley.
Yes.
Of bones in the book of Ezekiel 37.
Amen.
And the question and the answer, Lord, you know.
Yeah, man.
And so we always look for some form of confirmation when we preach.
Yes, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so because of the guidance of this pastor, because we just don't have church like we used to anymore.
Okay. Amen.
So he opened us up with some testimony.
Yes.
And along with that testimony, there was some worship and and some praise.
That's right.
And so immediately we knew that the Lord was leading us in the right direction.
Amen.
And so if you have a Bible with you,
amen.
And certainly we pray that you do. Mm-hmm. We invite your attention once again to the Old Testament. Mm-hmm. We preach these 3 nights out of the Old Testament. I'm a gospel preacher.
Uh-huh.
For some reason, the Lord wants us to tarry here.
Yeah. Right.
So I don't mind waiting on the Lord.
Go ahead, preacher.
So turn with me to the book of Psalms.
Amen.
Psalms 34.
Mm-hmm.
An old familiar passage of scripture that I'm sure that all of you are familiar with. It is a Psalm of David. Psalm 34, we shall find these words recorded. And David said, I will bless the Lord at all times.
Amen.
His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Go ahead, preacher.
My soul shall make her boast of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
The humble shall hear of it and be glad.
Really?
Oh, magnify the Lord with me.
Thank you, Lord.
And let us exalt his name.
Read it, preacher.
Together.
Mm-hmm.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
If it is the Lord's will on this Wednesday night of our revival, let us use for a preaching topic, a subject, or a thought tonight. There is power,
yes, sir,
in the praise.
Right. Yes, sir.
There is power in the praise.
Amen.
There is power, mm-hmm, wonder-working power.
Thank you, Lord.
In the praise.
Amen.
As I was meditating on our text tonight, my mind went back to one of those old church revival meetings. One of those meetings when they would be praising God, mm-hmm, from whom all blessings flow. In those old revival meetings, they were saying, nobody knows the trouble that I see. They would begin to sing, this old building, it keeps on leaning. And I've got to move to a better home. Some of those old revival meetings, the preacher didn't even have a chance to preach.
That's right.
Because the spirit was so high,
yes,
and the singing was,
yes,
so good.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Am I right about it?
Yeah.
Well, in our text tonight, we find David's testimony,
yes, sir,
about the power and the importance of praising God.
Yes.
The Bible says in Psalm 148, we were created to praise God.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
The Bible says, let them praise the name of the Lord.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
For he commanded and they were created.
Oh, yeah.
In order to feel the fullness of this revival celebration,
mm-hmm,
praising God must be the forefront of our celebration tonight.
Yeah.
Because God inhabits the praise of God. His people. And if you want to leave this revival,
thank you, Lord.
If you want to leave it restored and reconciled, you need to start praising,
oh, yeah,
God.
Yeah.
Amen.
The Bible says in 2 Chronicles 20 and 21,
yeah,
that after the consulting, Jehoshaphat appointed men to sing to the Lord and to praise him in the splendor of his holiness.
Yeah.
Said the Bible said that he sent them out ahead of the army.
Oh, yeah.
They were giving thanks to the Lord for his love, and his love endures forever.
Oh, yeah.
Well, as they began to sing and praise the Lord said, David extended the invitation to us as well.
Yes, sir.
David said, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. But can I help somebody tonight?
Hallelujah.
Because as I look out over the church, I see that somebody needs some help. You don't even have to have money to praise the Lord. David is simply saying, let us exalt his name together.
Let us
bring our heavy burdens. Let us bring our cares and our worries. Let us bring our confusion and our doubts. Changes is how we view God. What changes greater than we are. Who is in control. Whatever happens in your life happens because there is a God. And when we magnify the Lord, we will discover that whatever else we might think, it was God who did it. That cancer that has left your body, it was God. The reason that we are here tonight for this revival service, Mount Hebron, it is because there is a God. The degrees, the certificates, the diplomas, it was God. The good job, the good wife, the good husband, the good boo and the good babe. Stop looking at God through human eyes. Stop looking at God through human lenses that minimize and make God less than who he is. Stop looking at God through rose-colored glasses that don't give God credit for being God. All David is trying to say is that we should try to look at God another way. For some of us tonight, this is a new beginning. And for others, the journey continues after this revival. But I've stopped by to let you know that there is power in the praise. But just in case you don't understand my logic, all I'm trying to tell you is that you can find real praise when there is praying power. When there is preaching power. When there is shouting power in the midst of a worshiping church. I'm not talking about weak praise and lukewarm worship. I'm talking about true worship and true praise. David insisted that our praise must magnify God. He insisted that our praise is the product of our environment and our pride. And I don't know about you tonight, but I'm not ashamed to say that I have some problems.
Yes,
had problems with a prophet by the name of Nathan. Had problems with a prophet called Absalom. beloved, what David was saying. I'm going to bless the Lord whether he blesses me or not. No matter what happens, I'm going to bless the Lord. Come what may, I'm going to bless the Lord. No matter how dark the night, I'm still going to bless the Lord. In poverty and in plenty, I'm going to bless the Lord. When I have no bills and money, I'm going to bless the Lord. When the doctor gives me a bad report, I'm going to bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Even at the hands of evil brothers, I'm going to bless the Lord. When I'm forsaken, and for God, I'm going to bless the Lord.
Yes.
Because I found out that my circumstances would draw me closer to the Lord.
Yes.
I found out if I keep the Lord as the head of my life, he'll turn my burdens into my blessing.
Yes.
I found out that he would turn my heartaches into my hallelujahs.
Yes.
I found out I may have to go through disgrace, but at the end of the road is dignity.
Right.
I found out that he will take me through some grief in order that I may find some glory.
Yeah.
I must admit, I really don't know.
Jesus.
I really don't know.
Man.
I don't know how this blessing God thing works. But one thing I do know, I serve a God that specializes in taking new feet out of the miry clay. The God that I serve, he specializes in being a best friend if you don't have a friend. This God that I specialize, that I know he specializes in bringing down mountains and he levels out valleys. This God that I serve, he is a way maker and a top fixer. This God that I serve is a burden bearer and a heavy load shaker. This God that I serve is a rock and a weary land. He is shelter in time of a storm. He's water in a dry place. He's water when you're hungry and bread when you're thirsty. He's a bridge over troubled water. And when I think about it, how good he has been. When I think about it, how he kept me and he never left me. I think my mind says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my life. And John's word became flesh. He is the acts coming of the Holy Ghost. He is the chief potentate. He is the propitiation of all of our faith. He is Lord God all by himself. yourself. Magnify the Lord. And magnify the Lord with me. Come, let us praise his name together.